You're multifaceted beings, but there are only really two aspects of you that we want to bring your attention to, and that's the non-physical part of you and the physical part of you. And often, in your physical form, you think that you are only the physical part of you, that you left the non-physical part behind when you became physical. In other words, it's dead or alive. It's non-physical or physical. But most humans don't really get it, that you are non-physical energy focused in this physical body, and that some of the energy that is you is both non-physically focused and physically focused. And the non-physical part of you stays always riding the edge of creation. In other words, the non-physical part of you holds itself never endingly in that vibrational awareness of worthiness, of blessedness, of all things are possibleness. In other words, that non-physical part of you knows who you really are and never blinks for a moment from that knowing. While the physical part of you is out here banging around, knowing what you don't want, knowing what you do want, and that's not a bad thing. That's the way you intended it to be. You knew that you were the leading edge, pioneer, so to speak, of this consciousness that is always in a state of becoming. So you said, I'll go forth into this physical body and I will explore, and automatically, out of knowing what I don't want, I will know more clearly what I do want. And you said that whether you were a genius human or one of your magnificent beasts or a one-cell organism. In other words, all consciousness understands that it has at its basis a non-physical source or soul or spirit or inner being or whatever you're wanting to call it that is actively alive and present while you are focused.